Okay, any questions you have about the material we covered? Like whatever we talked about last time. I think you had a question about what do we mean by this notation. So I will, if you don't have any questions, so let's review what we were doing. We were talking about using x1, x2, and x3 rather than x, y, and z as coordinate axes. The unit vectors are e1, e2, and e3. We had discussed that ei dotted with ej, what is ei dotted with ej equal to?
Kronecker delta.
Kronecker delta, very good. And please press your button when you answer the question. So this is Kronecker delta. Now, what will this quantity be equal to? First of all, how many numbers will I get on the right-hand side? So I have delta ij, aj. How many numbers will I get on the right-hand side? So j is a summed index. But what about I?
Me.
I is a free index. So I can be 1, or 2, or 3. Okay? So I can be 1, 2, or 3. So if I is 1, what is this equal to? So this is sum of three terms. Like delta 1 1 a 1 plus delta 1 2 a 2 plus delta 1 3 a 3. But what is delta 1 2 equal to? It's 0, because unless I is equal to j, you get 0. So this is 0, that's 0, so you just get A1, because delta 1, 1 is 1. So what will be then this equal to? A2. Again, you write the sum of three terms, but two of them are zeros. So you basically get only A2. So now let's go back to this one then. So what's delta ij, aj equal to? Ai. So this is, these are three terms. And now I can be 1, 2, and 3. Yeah, please speak up. I think you can press the button and then you can ask the question. Instead of asking him the question, you should ask me the question. So another way of looking at this thing would have been, we talked about delta ij last time. You said it's an identity matrix. Like, it's a unit matrix or identity matrix. So if you write delta ij as identity, A is a vector. So identity matrix operating upon a vector will give you what? The same vector. So this thing is identity operating upon A will give you A. That's what we wrote here, delta ij, aj is ai. Does it make sense? Now, let's talk about the cross product. So what is E1 cross product E1 equal to? So this X here is the cross product between two vectors. So if you take the cross product of a vector with itself, what do you get? If you take the cross product of a vector with itself, you get
zero.
And this thing is good only in three-dimensional space. The cross product is not defined if you have a four-dimensional space or a five-dimensional space. So we are restricting ourselves to a three-dimensional space. So this is 0. What about E1 times E2? Sorry, cross E2. E3, very good. And we can keep on going. So we will have a E1 cross E3. That will be equal to what? It's negative E2. So next time we take like E2 cross E1, E2 cross E2, E2 cross E3. So what we have is nine of these quantities. Right? I goes from 1 to 3. J goes from 1 to 3. So you have 3 square, which means 9 quantities. So to write all 9 of them in one equation, we introduce a symbol epsilon I J K. Now how many of these quantities do we have? Epsilon I J K. I goes from 1 to 3. J goes from 1 to 3, K goes from 1 to 3. So you have 3 times 3 times 3, 27 of these. Okay? Now 27 of these are defined, so this is a definition. So you cannot say why. Because if somebody like my mom named me Ramesh, you cannot say why now, right? Because that's the name she gave me. So that's basically what it is here now. So you cannot question now why we are defining like that. This is the definition. So it's 1 or minus 1 or 0. When it is 1, when I, J, and K, they form an even permutation of 1, 2, 3. Now, what is an even permutation? Since many of us do not have clocks that have needles that turn around, so you may or may not know what is clockwise and what is counterclockwise. It's true, because now all of our, we have digital watches. So when I was your age, we did not have digital watches. So we had a clockwise and counterclockwise business. Okay, so write 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3 in a line. Okay, so write 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. You can start from any place you like, but you have to go to the right. So if you start from here, so you have 3, 1, 2. But if you start from say this place, you will have 1, 2, 3. Or you will have 2, 3, 1. So you have to go to the right. And that will give you an even permutation of 1, 2, 3. By even here, we don't mean like 2, 4, 6. It's an even permutation, not an even number. So if you go from left to right, no matter from where you start, that will be an even permutation and you will get 1, which really means now that epsilon 1, 2, 3 or 2, 3, 1 or 3, 1, 2, they're 1. So what will be an odd permutation? If even is you go from left to right, and then odd will be, you go from right to left. So if you say epsilon 3, 2, 1, or 2, 1, 3, or 1, 3, 2, so they will be minus 1. So minus 1 is when we have an odd permutation of 1, 2, 3. And plus 1 is when we have even permutation of 1, 2, 3. Okay. And it is 0 if any two indices like I, J or K, if any two or all three of them are equal. So that means like if you have epsilon 1, 1, 2, that means I and J are equal, so that will be 0. Or you have 1, 2, 1 or 1, 3, 1. So how many non-zero do we have? These are, there were 27 entries, I, J, and K. Each went from like 1 to 3. So we had 27 of those. Out of 27, how many are zeros?
21.
Okay. Three of them are 1. Three of them are minus 1. And the remaining 21 are zeros. Okay. So how do we use this now? So let's go back to our cross product between these vectors. So EI cross EJ, if I write this as epsilon IJK EK, now I have written all 9 cross products. So in this equation I wrote in this one, what are the free indices? So what indices are free? In this equation in the box, what indices are free? I and J. So how many terms do we have here then? 9. Very good. Can you please press that button so other people can hear it? Oh, you don't have it. Okay. Sorry. Okay. So since I goes from 1 to 3 and J goes from 1 to 3, so we have 9 of these. And that's what you had here. E1 cross E1, E1 cross E2, E2 cross E1 cross E3, then E2 cross E1, E2 cross E2, E2 cross E3. So you had 9 of those. Now we have written all 9 of them in 1. So if I set I equal to 1 and J equal to 1, I will get E1 cross E1 equal to 1, 1. But epsilon 1, 1 is 0. So it makes no difference whether you sum on K or you don't sum on K. Remember, on the right-hand side, there are 3 terms. K is repeated. So there are, it's a sum of 3 terms. So if you set I equal to 1 and J equal to 2, so we will get 2, we got 1, 2, K, E, K. If you set I equal to 1 and J equal to 2, so you get E1 cross E2 equal to epsilon 1, 2, K, E, K, but now it's summed on K, right? So if you sum it, first term you will get is 1, 2, 1, E1. But what is 1, 2, 1, E1? 0, because you have 2 indices on epsilon repeated. And then if you plus, it's epsilon 1, 2, 2, E2. And that's again 0, because you have 2 now coming twice on epsilon. So then plus epsilon 1, 2, 3, E3, and that's 1, because epsilon 1, 2, 3 is 1. Okay, so this one you get as then E3, and that's what we should be getting. Okay, so what we have learned then is how to take the cross product and how to take the dot product between two vectors. So in our index notation, u dot v equals what? in our index notation. Okay, we are not talking about ux, uy, uz now. We are talking about u1, u2, u3, v1, v2, v3 as the components. So this thing we said last time was ui, vi. So it's u1, v1 plus u2, v2 plus u3, v3. Now what about u cross v? So to see that, so we can write this as ui, ei, that's like u1, e1 plus u2, e2 plus u3, e3, cross uj, ej, sorry, vj, ej. Again, like it's u1, v1 plus u2, v2 plus u3, v3. V1, E1 plus V2, E2 plus V3, E3. Now U1, V1, these are scalars. The cross product is between vectors. So we can write this as UI, VJ, EI cross EJ. Does it make sense? The cross product is between vectors. It is not between scalars. Anyone has a question, either from Wake Forest or Oak Ridge? Are you okay?
Yes.
What about Wake Forest? Are you girls and guys? I think all of you are girls probably there. Because at least if my, well, you can't see anything here, right? You cannot tell from the pictures, but I can only tell from the names. Because all the names I think I saw were of the females. Like Melissa, Carrie, and so on. Catherine. Mm-hmm. Are you okay?
Yes.
Yes.
Good. So now, let's write EI cross EJ. We just learned that EI cross EJ is epsilon ij k ek, right? We just said that ei cross ej is epsilon ij k ek. So let's substitute that in here. So we get ui vj epsilon I j k ek. U cross v is supposed to be a vector that's perpendicular to the plane of u and v. On the right hand side, we have this quantity e sub k, which is a vector. It is summed on k. So you will get three components of u cross v, one along e1, one along e2, and one along e3. Does it make sense? So if I want to find the component of, say, u cross v in the direction L, L can be 1, 2, and 3. Say I want to find the component, say, along x2 axis. What do I do? If I want to find the component of a vector along x2 axis, what should we do? Is my question making sense? You project it along onto the x2 axis. But what is the algebraic operation involved in projecting that vector onto x2 axis?
Dot product.
Dot product. Very good. So you take the dot product with E2, with the unit vector along x2 axis. So in this case, I am not choosing a particular axis. Like I'm not saying x2, it could be x1, it could be x2, it could be x3. And to do all three of them in one shot, we are writing L rather than saying L is 1, L is 2, and L is 3. So following his suggestion, so we take the projection which means take the dot product, with the unit vector E, L, where L can be 1, 2, or 3. So we are doing all three operations in one. And that is the beauty or the advantage of this index notation. Instead of writing three equations, you can write one. Okay? So if we substitute for U cross V from the top equation, we have ui vj epsilon ijk ek dotted with el. The dot product is between vectors. So the vectors here are EK and EL. So the dot product is between EK and EL. Other than numbers like UI, VJ, epsilon IJK, these are 1, 2, 3, U1, U2, U3, V1, V2, V3. These are just numbers. So what is EK dot EL equal to? Delta from Kronecker delta. So that is, we started with that, so that's delta KL. So you can replace EK dot EL by delta KL. Now, if you recall, we said delta IJ, AJ equals what? AI. Which means the summed index here, J is the summed index, that's replaced by the free index I. So now in this one, this exercise we are doing, we have K as the summed index. So if you think of all of this thing as AK, then we have AK delta KL. Remember, now in this quantity, the one I put in the box here, K is the only free index. I and J are summed. Okay? So this thing is basic. There is only K that is floating around. So I can set this equal to AK. I can write the quantity in the black box I have there as AK, and then I have AK delta KL. Am I making sense? I mean, some of you seem to be happy with it. Others are discontent, but you are. But I can see from your faces that you are not happy. And it's, so the key is, please study at home. You have to practice. It is not a novel that you can read. You have to write with hand, make mistakes, spend time on it, and then it will be easy for you to pick it up. And you are welcome to stop by my office if you have any questions. But there is really no other way except to practice, practice, practice. It's math. And unfortunately, at least the only way I know to learn math is to do problems. There may be other ways that I do not know, but the way that has helped me is to do problems. So that's the only thing I can recommend then, is to do problems. Those of you who know some other ways, please tell your colleagues and you can exchange information. So one way is to do problems, and I think there are many problems, or there are some problems in every book. So if you open a book, you should be able to follow it. Okay, so AKL delta L will give me then AL. So now So this thing is then equal to ui vj epsilon ij. Because a, this box thing was ak, so ak delta kl is al, so now I'm putting back the value of a. So what we have learned is then that u cross v, the lth component of this is epsilon I j l u I v j. Right? So what we have learned is that u cross v is lth component is epsilon I j l u I v j. Now remember, one way to, I guess I should not use the word remember many times, but here, one way to keep this thing in mind is, since L appears at the end, that's really not very easy to keep in mind. But epsilon ijl is same as epsilon jli, so long as you go from left to right, you are okay. There is no change in sign introduced. So I'm going like, I'm writing ijl, ijl, and then going from left to right. And this is the same thing as epsilon lij. Okay, so it's an even permutation. Like you write ijl, ijl. You can start from anywhere you like, but go from left to right. So ijl is same as jli is same as lij. And if we keep that in mind, then we can say that u cross vl is same as epsilon lij uivj. And then it's a little bit easier to recall whenever you need to, because this l is the same as that l. The L free index L on the left side is the same as the free index L here. And then you put I and J, or you put any other two indices you like. And then put this index, I goes with U, and the, or I, this index goes with the first vector you have here, and the second index goes with the second vector you have here. So we are going to practice this right now. And to practice this, I think you have, you should have learned this vector identity, u cross v cross w. So that's equal to u dotted with w v minus v dotted with w times u. So this vector identity holds no matter what vectors u, v, and w you take. And if you are rusty on it, like if you, when you have forgotten, then take u equal to 2i plus 3j plus 5k, v equal to any other number you like. Evaluate this, then take the cross product with w. So you evaluate the left-hand side and the right-hand side, and they should come out to be same. Now let's use the index notation to prove that indeed this identity holds. Okay? So that will give us a little bit more practice. So let's call this as A, because u cross v is a vector. A cross W equal to. So its lth component is equal to epsilon. That's the Greek symbol again. That's epsilon L I J A I W J. And incidentally, this epsilon we talked about, that 27 quantities, it has a name. It's sometimes called alternating tensor, but I have not used the word tensor yet. Okay. So let's not say that. So let's, this is called permutation symbol. And it's also called an alternating tensor, but we have not defined a tensor yet. So let's say it is called permutation symbol. Okay, so now what is AI equal to? So A is U cross V. So what is AI? U cross V is A. Now we want to find AI. That means you take the dot product of both sides with I, with EI. Take the dot product of both sides with EI. Right? I think one of you told me you take the projection. So that's what we are doing now. So AI is EI dotted with U cross V, and that's epsilon L M N U L V, so U M or U L V M E M. And this thing comes from the fact that we wrote right here. So U cross V is UI VJ epsilon IJ K EK. We wrote here U cross V is this quantity. So it's epsilon IJ K UI VJ EK. And that's what I'm doing now, that U cross V is this quantity. But in this one, the dot product is between EI and EN. And that is equal to delta EN. Again, N and N is summed. So this is equal to epsilon L M I U L V M. Or it is the same thing as saying I L M, epsilon I L M V L, sorry, U L V M. This is the same thing as saying epsilon I L M U L V M. Because on epsilon you can go from left to right. It's an, so long as you don't change the L M I M I L or I L M, is the same thing. You go, I think we wrote here IJL, IJL, so long as you go from left to right, you are okay. Pick any three, but go from left to right. And if you go from right to left, then you are introducing a minus sign. Okay, now, so we have so what we are trying to prove is this identity is true. And what we have done so far is we have written that A cross W, its Lth component is epsilon L I J A I W J. But what is A I? A I is this quantity. So that's epsilon I L M U L V M. WJ. So AI is this quantity. Does it make sense? Yes?
You have 3L.
You need to press on.
You have 3L.
I have many L's. You are right. So that's not good. So we have two. So we have 3 L's. That doesn't make sense. So we change this L to P. Three L's don't mean anything, okay? On the left-hand side, L is a free index. On the right-hand side, L must be a free index. Remember, this L here is a dummy index. So you can write any other letter you like. So that's why I switched to P rather than L. If I had kept 3 L's, the equation would have been meaningless. Okay, so what we have then is epsilon L I J, epsilon I P M, U P V M W J. Now, I need to interchange either L and I on the first one. Yeah, I need to interchange L and I on the first one because I want to use some identity, or I want to use a identity. Now, if I interchange L and I, what will happen? Sign will change. See, if you recall, epsilon 1, 2, 3 is 1. What is epsilon 2, 1, 3? Minus 1. So if you interchange any two indices, you introduce a minus sign. So this thing is then minus epsilon I L J epsilon I P M U P W M sorry V M W J. Because I interchange L and I, therefore I have to introduce a minus sign. So when you interchange the two indices, then the sign changes. You go from either plus 1 to minus 1 or minus 1 to plus 1. If the two indices are equal and you interchange, then nothing changes because 0 is equal to minus 0. So the reason I did this is the following. Because if you take this quantity, now how many terms do we have? How many terms do we have in this one? Okay, how many free indices do we have? 4, like L, J, P, and M. L goes from 1 to 3, J goes from 1 to 3, P goes from 1 to 3, and M goes from 1 to 3. So we have 3 to the power 4, which is 81. So we have 81 quantities. Now if we want to evaluate all 81 of them, I think we will be here till 4 o'clock. Since we cannot be here till 4 o'clock, so I will give you the answer. And the answer is the following. You take the first index. Well, first index is summed. Okay, so take the first free index on each. And so that gives you delta LP. Delta is at Kronecker delta. So take the first free index on each. epsilon. And now take the second, basically there's only one index left, so we don't have a choice. So we get delta j. So the way to remember, now unfortunately there is no other way to say it. We have to memorize it. But we are not done yet. There's one more term. Okay, so we have to memorize it. We will need this many times in the course. We will need it not only today, today I'm proving something, but we will need this identity. Identity means it holds always. So we will need this identity several times in the class, in the semester. So we need to remember it. So the way to remember it is, yes?
Up there where you changed epsilon lij to minus epsilon ilj, why didn't you just change it to epsilon ijl?
Oh, if I had done lij, so if I had gone ijl, then there would have been no switching in the signs. I could have done that, sure.
I was just wondering if there was some reason.
No, that, so. All I wanted I to be the first index. No, you are absolutely right. I could have done what you said, that I could have done IJL. Absolutely correct. No, there would have been nothing would have changed. The final answer will be same. Okay. Because what would have changed is, since I will have different indices on first epsilon, then the identity I'm going to write here will be different. Okay, so coming back to what is this equal to epsilon ILJ and epsilon IPM. So take the first index, first free index on each epsilon, and put it on delta. Now, take the first index, first free index on epsilon, and the second free index on the second epsilon. So that will be delta LM, now which there is a minus sign in between. And then JP. And as I said before, we basically have to remember it. And the way I remember it is the following, that first make sure that you have the summed index as the first index on epsilons. Or it could be the last index on epsilons. So the summed index, which in this case is I, is repeated, that should either be the first or the last. And then take the first free index on the first epsilon and the first free index on the second epsilon and put it on a Kronecker delta. And the same thing about the second free index on each. And now if you take the first free index with the second free index, there is a minus sign in between, and we are done. So we have these 81 quantities. Okay? Because L, P, J, and M, they go from, each one goes from 1 to 4, so you have 3 to the power 4, 81 quantities. Okay, now let's use this here. And then we should be able to prove that identity. So it's minus delta LP delta JM minus delta LM delta JP UP VM WJ. And now we again use this fact that delta ij, aj equals to ai. So we use this over and over. So you have p here and a p here. Right? So if we take this one, we will get minus delta lp, up. That will give me UL. JM, I have WJ, so that will give me WM, and then I have VM there. So that's my first term. Did I go too fast? I have delta LP, UP. So that gives us, by using this equation, that gives us UL. We have delta JM, WJ, that gives us WM. So this minus and minus becomes plus. LM, we have VM here. So that will make it VL. JP, we have WJ here. So that will make it WP and UP. We are almost done. So is the clock. I mean, it's almost noon. So what is this thing equal to now in vector notation? So we are going back now from index notation to vector notation. So what is WMVM in terms of vector notation, like inner product or dot or cross product? So that's W dot V. This is summed, right? M and M is summed. So that means it's W1V1 plus W2V2 plus W3V3. So this is minus UL W dotted with V. Plus VL W dotted with U. Right? So what we have shown is that A cross WL is equal to this. So L is the free index. So each component, basically now you can say L's component is equal to this, or what was A? A was U cross V cross W. So I'm going, A was U cross V, so I'm plugging it back now. So that's equal to minus U W dotted with V plus V W dotted with U. Because Lth component is, so all we are seeing that Lth component of this is the Lth component of that. So basically you are removing L now. And this is what we said, this identity is equal to. So that's what I said that you had learned before. And in the index notation, by using the index notation, we have basically proved it. So this was an exercise in using the index notation and that permutation symbol and this identity. So what did we learn today? If you want to summarize, so we learned basically three things. First, what we said was that delta ij, aj is ai. That was the first thing we learned, which means identity matrix operating upon a vector gives you the same vector. The second thing we learned is this permutation symbol. So that's like epsilon ij. What is the definition of epsilon ij k? So it's 1, minus 1, or 0. Okay, so we learned this definition of like epsilon ij k, this quantity. So that's the second thing we learned. It's a new symbol we introduced. And third, was that this identity